Good morning, good morning. We welcome Pastor Tommy Bell. We are so glad he's with us this morning, and we believe that he has a powerful word to share. And so we're going to turn it over to you, Pastor Bell.
Thank you, Sister Ramona. I hope this manna truly blesses you today. It's I'm taking the subject matter out of 2 Corinthians 13:5. It says, examine yourselves to see whether you're in the faith, or prove your own selves. And I want to come from the subject matter of fan or follower. Fan or follower. I believe that when any of us have been Christian for some time, we need to take a moment and examine our life actions, our life thoughts, and this question we need to ask is, am I a follower of Jesus? Now, this is to see where we are in our relationship to Christ or with Christ. So let me ask this question again. Are you a follower of Jesus? Now, you may be tempted to skip over that question, but don't do that, for I believe it is one of the most important questions we ever have to answer of being a follower of Jesus. Now, you may have been asked that question many times before, or have at least thought about it in your own minds. But because it sounds so familiar, there is this tendency to just dismiss it, kind of thinking it's redundant or at most unnecessary. For I'm doing this, I'm into this, I'm going here, I'm doing these things. But you have to ask that question of yourself at times to see where you really are. Now, we can look at Christians in a few ways. There's the what I call the fish on the back of the car group. This group is serious enough about their faith. They spend a lot of time in the Christian bookstore. They are avid readers of the history of religion and are great and of the great warriors of the faith. And when this question is asked, are you a follower of Jesus? When that comes up, it kind of needs clarifying in this day and time. You see, I'm not asking, do you go to church? I'm not asking, were you raised in a Christian home? Did you raise your hand at the end of the sermon? Did you repeat the prayer of the preacher? Or did you walk down the aisle to the tune of Just As I Am? Or do you own more than one Bible? Or what about witness clothing? Do you wear those? Or is the King James Bible the only Bible you use? Or do you put on your Facebook page, follower of Christ? Or is the ringtones on your phone a worship song? Or did you get a purpose-driven life in 40 days or less? Or are you in some form of ministry group? Here's the point I want to get across. Many of us are quickly to say, I am a follower of Jesus. But are you sure you truly understand what it means biblically? Fans are happy to follow Jesus as long as that doesn't require anything, any significant changes in their lives or have any negative complications or hard situations. Now, in chapter 7 of Matthew, the gospel tells us of the most heart-wrenching story of a group of people who thought they were followers of Jesus. And when it came time for them to stand before him in judgment, he says to them, depart from me, I never knew you. Now, which would you rather hear? Well done, good and faithful servant, you followed me, enter into the joy of the Lord, or I never knew you as you stand before God. Now, you may be a part of the second group. The question just doesn't seem to be relevant enough to you. It doesn't bother you that some people choose to follow Jesus wholeheartedly. It's just not your thing. Yes, you still want to control parts of your life. But what if all of life comes down to that one question? Are you a follower of Christ? What if there really is a heaven and really is a hell? And where we spend eternity comes down to that one question. Now, you see, that may seem ridiculous, but just in case there is some part of you that is considering this for just one minute possibility, then this question, are you a follower of Christ, is worth thinking through. So, where do we begin to find out if we are truly a follower of Jesus or just a fan? How do we decide if this is something we choose to be and do? We need to have what they call a DTR time, meaning a defining the relationship time. You want to see where you stand and if that stand is for real. Two people, imagine with me, two people meet on a date. They take a booth in the rear of the restaurant and begin an awkward conversation. This is their first date. They begin to learn things about each other while they're eating their dessert. And she now asks the fella, where do you see this relationship going? This is the first date. Now, you can guess the response and the action of this fella. There probably won't be any more dates with her. Well, there comes a time when we need to take a moment and define our relationship with Christ. We need to know whether is it casual or is it truly committed. Have things move past infatuation and admiration and towards deeper devotion and dedication? This evaluation stated must be done intentionally about your level of commitment to the person and with the person, Jesus Christ. So let me share an imaginary illustration with you. Picture in your mind yourself walking into the local coffee shop. You grab your snack and your preferred drink, and then you walk toward the back where it isn't crowded. You find a seat at a small table. You take a sip of your drink and enjoy a few quiet minutes alone. Now imagine, while you're sitting there, you look up and you see Jesus coming in. You know it's Jesus because of the way he's dressed in royalty. He comes down and sits across from you. Now you're unsure what to say. So you quickly think and ask, can you turn my drink into wine? He gives you that same look that he gave to Peter, one of disgust. You start to pray over your meal nervously. You say something like, I love you more dearly. I want to see you more clearly. I want to follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. Then Jesus looks at you and he skips the small talk and cuts right to the point. He says to you, it's time to define this relationship. He says, I want to know how you truly feel about me. Am I exclusive or is it just a casual thing with you? What do you truly say at that point? How is your relationship with him defined. What exactly is your level of commitment? I believe if Jesus were sitting across from you and asking you, are you a follower of me? It would be a little more challenging to answer that question as you look back over your life. Many of us today who ascribe to the ideal of being a follower of Christ, our more suitable word would be not follower, but fan. You see, the most basic definition of a fan is, it is one who goes to the sporting events, no shirt, no matter the weather, with painted face and chest. He sits in the stands and cheers for his team. He's got signed jerseys on his wall at home, multiple stickers on the back of his car, but he's never in the game. He never breaks a sweat or takes a hard hit in the open field. He knows all about the players. He can rattle off the latest stats, but he may not know the players. He yells and cheers, but nothing is really required of him. There is no sacrifice he has to make. And the truth is, as excited as he is, if his team starts to let him down, his passion will drop quickly, and you can expect him to jump off the fan wagon and go to another team. I think Jesus has a lot of fans today, ones that will cheer for him when things are going well, when the blessings are pouring down into their lives, but feel betrayed when they don't, and they'll walk away. You see, fans who sit safely in the stands cheering, they know nothing of the sacrifice and the pain on the field. Fans of Jesus know all about him, but they truly don't know him. Jesus was never interested in fan clubs. When he defines what kind of relationship he wants, enthusiastic admirers wasn't an option. Could it be that the biggest threat to the church today is fans who call themselves Christians but aren't interested in truly following Christ? They want to be close enough to him to get all the benefits, but not so close that it requires everything from them. So, let me ask that question in conclusion. Are you a follower or a fan? Thank you.